Hey guys, welcome to iSpecs. In this video, I'll show you how to install Ubuntu on Oracle VM VirtualBox on Windows. Before getting started, consider subscribing to this channel. Now, if you've done that, let's get started. First, download the latest available version of Oracle VM VirtualBox Manager and latest available stable version of Ubuntu ISO file. Official links for both are available in the video description. Now install Oracle VM VirtualBox Manager. It's straightforward. In case if your computer couldn't connect to internet after installing the software, since it has reset the network interface, open Windows System Settings, go to Troubleshoot Options, and Troubleshoot Internet Connections. Now open VirtualBox Manager. Here you'll have to create a new virtual machine. To do that, click on New and give it a relevant name. It will automatically select the OS type. Click on Next and here select the amount of RAM to be allocated for this virtual machine and click Next. Minimum 1 GB is recommended. For hard disk, leave it as default and click Create. Again, leave it as default for hard disk type and click Next. Now here you can choose either of them. Read the text and select whichever is convenient for you and click Next. Here select the storage size of virtual machine, minimum 15 GB is recommended and click Create. Virtual machine is now created and now you need to install Ubuntu on it. Select the virtual machine and click Settings. Go to Storage and under Controller IDE select Empty, click on this icon and choose a disk file. Locate the Ubuntu ISO file, open it and click OK to close. Now start the virtual machine. Here select Ubuntu for startup disk and click Start. Select your preferred language and click Install Ubuntu. Then select the keyboard layout and continue. Choose normal or minimal installation whichever is convenient for you and you can also check this option for third-party software for media and all. Click Continue and leave this as default and click Install. A window will open, just click Continue. Next, select your location and click Continue. Here, enter your name and set the username and login password and finally click Continue to begin the installation. It may take up to 30 minutes to install and after the installation is done, it will ask you to restart Click Restart Now to restart the virtual machine. After that, it will ask you to remove the installation medium, that is the ISO file. Open its location and you can rename the file or folder or move to different location or delete if you don't want it anymore. Then go back to the virtual machine and press enter. Enter the login password, skip these welcome things and that's it. Ubuntu installation is done now. But as you can see, the screen is not getting bigger or fitting to the actual display size. So to get that, go to devices here and install guest additions CD image. Now it will show prompt to install it. Click run and then enter password. In case if you get an error like this, power off the machine, click on settings, go to storage and make sure the disk under controller IDE is empty. If it's not empty, select the disk, click on this icon here and remove disk from virtual drive and click OK to close the settings and start the machine again. Go to devices, install get addition CD image. Now the prompt should open for you. Click run and enter the password and installation will begin, and if the installation is done, restart the machine and you will get the full screen. If you get error like this, system is currently not set up to build kernel modules, close this window, connect your computer to internet if it's not already connected. Open terminal and enter these commands, and you need to enter login password to run these commands. Both commands are available in the video description. Restart the machine once it's done and that's it. Hope you found this video useful, and if you do, give a like. If you get any problems or error with this, feel free to ask them in the comment section below. Subscribe to this channel for more informative tech videos and also turn on notifications to get notified when we publish a new video. Thanks a lot for watching, iSpecs. Have a wonderful day.